What's up, peers, and welcome to the World Crypto Network with a reading of the Bitcoin OPTECH newsletter number 15 on October 2nd, 2018. This week's newsletter includes notice of Bitcoin Core 0.17 impending release, links to the backport release of Bitcoin Core version 0.15 and 0.14 to fix the CVE duplicate input bugs for those users unable to run the most recent release, a brief description of a chain split on testnet, and links to notable merges in Bitcoin's infrastructure project. Action items: upgrade to Bitcoin Core 0.17. The new release has been tagged and several people have begun reproducing builds of the software, so that the binaries and formal release announcements are likely to become available on Tuesday or Wednesday on bitcoinorg.com. The announcement will include a copy of the release notes detailing major changes to the software since version 0.16 release. News: Bitcoin Core version 0.15.2 and version 14.3 releases. Although source code has been available for these old branches since the public announcement of the duplicate input bug, getting enough people to certify a reproducible build took extra time before the binaries could be made available. The CVE duplicate input exploit on testnet. Last Thursday, a block was created on testnet containing a transaction that spent the same input twice. As expected, nodes believed to be vulnerable to the bug accepted the block, and all other nodes rejected it, leading to a consensus failure, a chain split, where the chain with the most proof of work contained the duplicate inputs and a weaker chain did not. Eventually, the chain without the duplicate input gained more proof of work and the vulnerable nodes attempted to switch to it. This caused the vulnerable nodes to attempt to re-add the duplication input to the UTXO database twice, triggering an assert and causing them to shut down. When restarted, operators of the vulnerable nodes needed manual trigger to a lengthy re-index procedure to fix their nodes' database inconsistencies. The side effect of recovering from a duplicate input chain split was previously known to developers. Nodes upgraded to Bitcoin Core versions 0.16.3 and 0.17 release candidate 4 or running other software that wasn't vulnerable have no reported problems. However, many block explorers with a testnet mode did accept the vulnerable block, providing a reminder that users should be careful about using third parties to determine whether or not transactions are valid. Notable code changes. Notable code changes this week in Bitcoin Core, LND, and C-Lightning. Bitcoin Core merge: after the discovery of a few cases where Python-based tests were passed incorrectly as a result of using misnamed variables, a variable name whitelist was implemented using Python 3's slot feature for classes. LND merge: the new witness address RPC has been removed and the new address RPC now only supports generating address of the paid to script hash wrapped paid to witness public key, paid to witness key hash and native paid to witness public key hash. A C-Lightning merge: the invoice RPC now implements route boost by including a bold 11 R parameter in the invoice that provides routing information to the payer of an already open channel that has the capacity to supporting paying the invoice. The parameter was originally intended to help support private routes, but it can also be used this way to support nodes that no longer want to accept Lightning invoice new incoming channels. Alternatively, if no available channel can support payments of the invoice, C-Lightning will emit a warning. P Peers, subscribe to the Bitcoin Optech newsletter, and thank you very much to all the contributors making this possible. As always, thank you very much and see you on the next show. Bye-bye.